Hello friends, welcome to my channel. Once again, I request you to please like, share, comment and subscribe this channel so that we can give you better videos. Now, in the previous videos, we were doing friction. This is in mechanics of machines of third sem. We were doing friction. We completed the numericals on bearings. Now, I am going to take up friction in clutch. Now, what is a clutch? Clutch is defined as a machine element, a part of a machine part, which transmits power from one shaft to another shaft at will. This is important. At will means here the power transmission can be affected or broken or removed. They can be joined or removed. The two shafts, one is the driver shaft and the other one is the driven shaft. These two shafts can be either engaged or disengaged in any condition. At will means in any condition, even in rotating condition, they can be disconnected or they can be assembled, which is not possible if you transmit power with the help of couplings. If you are transmitting power from one shaft to another shaft by using a coupling, if you want to disconnect them, you have to stop, remove the keys, bolts, nuts, etc., and then physically separate them. Now, that is not there in a clutch. It can be done in running condition only. So we say it transmits power from one shaft to another shaft at will. Now, these clutches are broadly classified into two types. One is called the positive clutch and the other one is called the friction clutch. We do not have this positive clutch. We have only friction clutch. They are called friction clutches because the power is transmitted from the driver to the driven shaft due to friction at the contact surface. That's why it is called as the friction clutch. So in a clutch, in a friction clutch, friction is desirable, wanted. We want to increase it to as much extent as possible. So what we do is the contact surfaces are lined with materials which have very high coefficient of friction. But it cannot be infinitely increased. Up to certain limit you can increase it. Anyway, the friction is desirable. And in numericals, again you get a numerical in clutch. You get one numerical in bearing about 6 to 8 marks. You get one numerical in clutch again for 6 to 8 marks. You will get it on friction clutch. So when you get problem on clutch, usually they will tell assume uniform wear. Why we assume uniform wear is because friction is desirable. In a bearing problem, generally they ask us to assume uniform pressure because their friction is undesirable. The treatment is similar, the formulae are similar here. The friction clutches are further classified into three types. One is plate, or they are also called as disc clutches, D-I-S-C, disc clutch, cone clutch, centrifugal clutch. Now we have only this plate clutch. We don't have those clutches. In this, there are two types. One is called as single plate clutch, single plate or single disc clutch, and the other one is multi plate or multi disc clutch. So these two we have got. These two, they can ask you to explain the working of these clutches with the help of sketches. I advise you to go to the channels where in YouTube you have got a number of channels where they show the animated this thing. You can understand it better when you see those clutches in working condition, which I cannot show. I will be concentrating mostly on problems, numericals. Now they can ask a problem either on single plate clutch or on multi-plate clutch. Now I will briefly explain you how it works. Here I'll first take up the single plate clutch. Now a single plate clutch in its simplest, bare simplest form will be like this. This is a driving shaft, let us say. A disc or plate is keyed to it. So this is the driving shaft. So this is rotating. Whenever this rotates, this will also rotate. Here lining is provided. Lining is provided here. This is the lining. The material of the lining will be it will be having higher coefficient of friction. On the driven shaft also, there is the driven shaft will be a spline shaft. On that also there will be a plate, and this is connected. This can be slided over the driven shaft. The power is to be transmitted from this shaft to that shaft. So whenever you want the power to be transmitted, you push this plate with a axial force, which is exerted through a number of helical springs. Now this plate, when it is pushed, goes and gets pressed against this. Now this is rotating. Due to that contact between these two, this will also start rotating. This will also rotate. Now the contact surface will be like this. The contact surface will be like this. This will be the contact surface here. Now this is small r, internal radius, and this is the capital R. Now if you assume uniform pressure, same formula which we used in uniform pressure. We don't use uniform pressure here, we use uniform wear, but the formula will be W will be PB into pi into r square minus small r square, so many kilo Newton, and T will be 2 by 3 mu W into r cube minus r cube divided by r square minus r square, kilo Newton meters. If you assume uniform wear, this is what you are going to assume here. Generally, assuming uniform wear, you will get W is equal to 2 pi PB into small r multiplied by capital R minus small r, so many kilo Newton. T will be equal to half mu W into R plus R, kilo Newton meter. These are the formulae. Once you get torque, then you can get the power transmitted. Here we don't say power lost. Here we say power transmitted by the clutch will be equal to again 2 pi nt by 60. Same thing. Now if it is both sides effective, in case of a single plate clutch having both sides effective, means what? Means there will be a housing here which will press like this. This housing will press this plate. Imagine that this is the plate, it will come. So there will be power transmission this side also, there will be power transmission this side also. Then if they say a single plate clutch having both sides effective, then what happens is T will be double this. T will be 2 by 3 mu W into R cube minus R cube divided by R square minus R square into 2, assuming uniform pressure. Whenever you assume uniform pressure, if you assume uniform wear, T will be half mu W into R plus R, again into 2, if you assume uniform wear. Generally single plate clutch will have both sides effective. So instead of this formula, we'll be using those formula there in this thing. So this is a simple way of explaining it. This much sketch, if you put, that is enough for a single plate clutch, working of a single plate clutch. Then, if it is multi-plate clutch, if it is a multi-plate or multi-disc clutch, multi-plate clutch or multi-disc clutch, there will be a number of plates on driving shaft and a number of plates on the driven shaft. Now, when they come in contact, suppose there are three plates on the driving shaft and two on the, this thing in the housing, it will come like this. So they get, they join like this, they are transmitting power. The number of contact surfaces, number of plates is 5. The number of contact surfaces will be 4. So that number of contact surfaces is called as N. N is number of contact surfaces here. Now this number of contact surfaces will be equal to total number of plates or discs, total number of discs, that is both driver and driven shaft, minus 1. See, if you have 5, 3 plus 2, the number of contact surfaces will be 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. If you have 4 plus 3, 7 plates, the number of contact surfaces will be 6. 7 minus 1, that will be 6. So this is this thing. Now, in this case, assuming uniform pressure, which we will not assume, generally W will be PB into pi into R square minus R square kilonewton. T will be 2 by 3 mu W into R cube minus R cube divided by R square minus R square into N. In a bearing, N will come here. This is where the difference is. In a bearing, this N will come in load formula. In clutch, the N will come in the torque formula. So many kilonewton meters. Assuming uniform wear, again, W is 2 pi PB into R, small r, 2 pi PB into small r into capital R minus small r, so many kilonewtons, and T will be half mu W into R plus R, he multiplied by small n, so many kilonewton meters. So again, here also N will come in the torque formula, not in the load formula. This is what you have to remember. Then power is equal to 2 pi nt by 60. That finishes that. Now we will take up some problems on this and try to solve them. A couple of problems we'll solve on clutches. I'm taking the problems from the question bank. Let us solve these problems. I have selected problem number 11. It says a single plate clutch with both sides effective. Single plate clutch with both sides effective has outer and inner diameters of 300 mm and 200 mm. 300 mm outer dia and inner dia is 200 mm. Right. The maximum intensity of pressure at any point in the contact surface is not to exceed 0.1 Newton per mm square. if the coefficient of friction is 0.3, determine the power transmitted by the clutch at a speed of 2500 rpm. At this speed, what is the power transmitted? P is how much? P will be 2 pi n t by 60. Now this is a single plate clutch with both sides effective, and we are supposed to assume uniform wear. Assuming uniform wear, we have to find the power transmitted. Now, assuming uniform wear, the formula for T is half mu W into R plus R into 2, because it is both sides effective. Now, W is not given, so first we have to find out W. This will be 0.3 meter, this will be 0.2 meter, so this will be 100 kilonewton per square meter, and then this thing. So first you have to find out this W. W will be 2 pi pb into small r into r minus r. So 2 into pi into this is 100 into r. Capital R will be 0.15 meter, half of this. Small r will be half of this, that is 0.1 meter. 100 into 0.1 into 0.15 minus 0.1. That is, that will give me W in kilonewtons. 0.15 minus 0.1, that is 0.05, multiplied by 0.1, multiplied by 100 into 2 into pi. That gives me 3.14 kilonewtons. This is axial force W. Now this W is to be used there. T is equal to half into mu is 0.3 into W is 3.14 into R plus R, that is 0.15 plus 0.1 multiplied by 2. These two can be cancelled. So 0.25 into 3.14 into 0.3. That gives me 0.2355. T is equal to 0.2355 kilonewton meter. So P is 2 pi nt by 60. That is 2 pi into 2500, I think, is the speed, into 0.2355 divided by 60. That is, this multiplied by 61.65 kilowatts. 61.65 kilowatts. This is the power transmitted by the clutch under those conditions. Next, I have selected problem number 12 from the question bank. It says a multi-disc clutch has 5 plates having 4 pairs of active friction surfaces. So there are 5 plates, so n will be 4, 5 minus, he himself has given it as 4. If the intensity of pressure is not to exceed, PB, bearing pressure, is not to exceed 0.127 newton per mm square, calculate the power transmitted at 500 rpm. The outer and inner radii of the friction surfaces are 125 mm and 75 mm. Here outer and inner radii. That means R is 125 mm. R is 125 mm. You must be careful. Sometimes dia is given, sometimes radius is given. 75 mm. Respectively, assume uniform wear and coefficient of friction is mu is 0.3. So this is the given data. With this data, you have to find out the power transmitted. Now, this will be 127 kilonewton per square meter. This will be 0.125 meters. This will be 0.075 meters. First, convert these things. Now, first, you have to find out W. W, assuming we are assuming uniform wear. Assuming uniform wear, the formula is 2 pi Pb into R minus R. This is the formula. So 2 pi into Pb is 127. R, small r, is 0.075. Into capital R is 0.125 minus 0.075. This will give you the axial load in kilonewton. So 0.125 minus 0.075, subtract that, I get 0.05 into 0.075 into 125 into pi into 2. That gives me 2.945 kilonewton. This is axial force. Next, T is equal to half mu W into R plus R multiplied by N. Half mu is 0.3, W we have got 2.945. into R is 0.125 plus 0.075 into N is 4. So first add those two, 0.125 plus 0.075 gives me 0.2 into 4 into 2.945 into 0.3 divided by 2. That gives me 0.3534 kilonewton meter. This is the torque transmitted. So power transmitted will be 2 pi nt by 60. That is 2 pi into n is 500 into t is 0.3534 divided by 60. So this, I get it as 18.5 kilowatts. This is the power transmitted by the clutch. So friends, I have done two problems in clutch. If you have any other problem, you can always ask me to do it. If you have any difficulty, you can ask me. You please subscribe the channel. Thank you.